बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। टुडेज़ टॉपिक इज़ हु किल्ड अबू जहल। अबू जहल नेम्ड अबुल हकम अमर बिन हिशाम, नोन एज अबू जहल मीन्स फादर ऑफ इग्नोरेंस, इज द पैटर्नल अंकल ऑफ प्रॉफिट मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम एंड द डेडलीस्ट एनिमी ऑफ इस्लाम एंड प्रॉफिट मोहम्मद। ही वॉज द लीडर ऑफ द कुरैश, अ स्टोन हार्टेड टायरेंट, एंड लाइक द टायरेंट्स ऑफ एवरी एरा ही टू वॉज ह्यूमिलेटेड एंड डिसग्रेस्ड बिफोर हिज डेथ इन द बैटल ऑफ बदर, and the almighty Allah was again manifested. Hazrat Abdul Rahman bin Auf radiyallahu ta'ala anhu narrates, I was standing in the battle line of Badr flanked by two young boys. One of them secretively asked, please can you tell me who is Abu Jahl? I asked, why? What business do you have with him? He answered, I have taken a vow to Allah ta'ala. Whenever Abu Jahl is seen by me, I will either kill him or die fighting, as he is a great enemy to the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I looked at this boy in astonishment while the second said the same thing. Soon afterwards, I saw Abu Jahl. He was moving about among men. I said to the two boys, don't you see? He is the man you were inquiring about. As soon as they heard this, the two brave young men drew their swords and walked towards that direction. Many mujahids were looking for Abu Jahl to kill him, just like those two young men. Before the two young men reached Abu Jahl, Muaz bin Amr bin Jamu from Ansar, who was following Abu Jahl, hit Abu Jahl on the leg with his sword. Ikrimah, the son of Abu Jahl, wounded his hand and arm with his sword in return. This heroic companion said, my hand was hanging down with its skin. I forgot about my hand due to the severity of the battle. I held my wounded hand at the back and continued fighting. When my hand started to give me a lot of trouble, I stepped on it with my foot and cut off my hanging hand. Hazrat Muaz radiyallahu ta'ala anhu fought and chased Ikrimah, who was later able to run away from him. The young Sahabi then continued to fight with others but found his hanging arm to be an obstruction to him. Hazrat Muaz radiyallahu anhu wound healed shortly thereafter, and he lived until the caliphate of Hazrat Sayyidina Usman Ghani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Then they returned to the Messenger of Allah, may peace be upon him, and informed him of this. He asked, which of you has killed him? Each one of them said, I have killed him. He said, have you wiped your swords? They said, no. He examined their swords and said, both of you have killed him. He then decided that the belongings of Abu Jahl be handed over to the two young boys, Muaz ibn Amr ibn al-Jamu and Ma'ud ibn Afra. Later on, Abdullah bin Mas'ud found Abu Jahl on the verge of death, breathing his last. He stepped on his neck, addressing him. Have you seen how Allah has disgraced you? The enemy of Islam still defiantly answered, I am not disgraced. I am no more than a man killed by his own people on the battlefield. And then inquired, who has won the battle? Ibn Mas'ud replied, Allah and his messenger. Abu Jahl then said, with a heart full of grudge, you have followed difficult ways, you shepherd. Ibn Mas'ud used to be a shepherd working for the Meccan aristocrats. Ibn Mas'ud then cut off his head and took it to the messenger of Allah, who on seeing it began to entertain Allah's praise. Allah is great, praise is to Allah, who has fulfilled his promise, assisted his servant and defeated the confederates alone. He then set out to have a look at the corpse. There he said, this is the pharaoh of the nation. Jazakallah.